It's okay, cause that's where I got my filter, my lid from. The Focus RS lid, I got mine from some website. I forgot what it's called, but they do. But it's like, once I found out about the RS, it's like I got a heat shield, and it's still and the filter's still covered versus making an actual cold air intake. I still have a lid over it, and I don't have to worry about heat soak, cause that motherfucker and that fucking engine heat soaks pretty fucking fast, and that shit pisses me off. And it doesn't help that the turbo, after about a few more hits, fucking dies down. And it's like, it's to the point where I can really feel it. Like, I could do like 3, 4 hits on a normal, warm day, but on the fifth hit, it's over. Because the turbo I have is a different turbo from the Focus ST. I can't use the one from the ST because the flanges are different. Yes, the ports are different, or whatever you call it. So, the one that they use is a KO3, while the one I use is a Twin Scroll from BorgWarner. It's like a new turbo that they're using for the newer Escapes. But the one that I'm look that I was looking at is a Garrett turbo. So that one's gonna be a bigger t it's a 52 millimeter versus a 42. So 52, so it's a 2870 something, hang on. It's a Garrett, it's like one of the, I don't know what they would call that. It's from their Power Max line. It's a direct fit. Shit, it's a Garrett Power Max, so it's a direct fit and an upgrade from the OEM. It's a so what is this shit? It's a Garrett 2876, I believe. Yeah, it's a yeah. It's only one, and it's only a stage one upgrade too. Yeah, but it still has like OEM parts, which I want because I still want to keep it OEM a little bit, but at the same time go like a bigger turbo. Yep, and if I do get my tune, oh shit, this is gonna be over. Maybe. Oh shit, bro, no, I'm not worried about the suspension because it for a fucking As for a car that weighs as much as a Hellcat, it fucking handles as good as like a Civic or a Miata. Yeah, like that thing handles surprisingly well for a fucking 4,300-pound car. And it's not even the top of the line trim level that I have too. I think the top of the line trim level has everything. But I just have the one. It's only like a step above the normal trim level. I have the SE. I think the normal trim level is S. So you got S, SE, SEL, then you got titanium. And I got SE. So that's only a step above the normal trim level. And yet it's fucking handling like that. Right? Shit. I found out because I was this fucking Civic was tailing my ass. So I was like, you know what? Let's see how this thing handles in the turn. Fuck. Fucking damn near held up against a fucking Civic, and fucking smoked them after. I mean, if you get the newer one, shit, you'd probably be a little faster if you get the newer one, because the newer one has the 8-speed. Yeah, and it's a little bit more aerodynamic. Well, no, it's less aerodynamic. No. Just no. No, bro, those are my fucking desserts. Those are my fucking desserts, bro. Oh, man, I'm telling you, man. Ah, those are lunch money right there. Because the fact that they're so heavy. That's why I'm able to beat fucking Tahoes, Yukons, fucking Silverados. Yeah, they're just way too fucking heavy. And I think one of them was a Denali, too. I didn't know until I looked back and I saw the Denali badge. I'm like, oh, okay. So I was like, you know what? I give them a chance, and I just fucking slowly walk them down. Like, the only thing that upsets me about Chevy is that they fucking made them heavy. That's the only shitty part. I mean, if they're a little lighter, oh, I would have lost. That shit's supercharged. No, the SS, the Silverado SS was supercharged. Yeah, with the Shelby. It's supercharged. Exactly. I mean, they already did it once. I mean, I don't know if they want to do it again. Yeah, with the cat eye Silverado. It was, it had four doors and it was whooping ass. But then, that was also the time where Ford had the Harley Davidson edition, which fucking kicked ass. Then Dodge still had the fucking 4.7, I believe, during that time. They had the 4.7, I believe, the 5. No, they didn't. No, then that was SRT. That was SRT 10. Slow as shit. Big engine in a big ass car. Slow as shit. Wasn't even competition anymore. Shit. Like, just in general, Dodge fucking builds powerful cars, but put them in the heaviest things in the world. Like, if the Charger was even a fraction of its weight, like, even just a smidge lighter, it'd fucking beat a lot of cars. Okay, I don't know about that, Chief, but... No, that wouldn't be safe. That'd be a safe hazard. That'd be a safety hazard if they made fiberglass. Cause fiberglass is thinner than metal. You make a fiberglass body with fiberglass. You make a fiberglass body, it's gonna be light. But you increased everything. You increased your wrinkle points. You increased your fucking, the chances of a car going right through you and breaking through. Like, shit. It's like, I would much rather buy a Nissan hard body than fucking buy a lightweight car that'll go fast. Yeah, I'd rather buy a Nissan hard body at that point. Cause fucking Nissan hard body, you'll come out there with just fucking bruises and scratches. Meanwhile, the guy's car will come out in pieces. Cause I mean, them hard bodies, they don't play around. There's a reason why Nissan called them a hard body. Dude, like, just fucking you knock on that thing, you know damn well you gonna be safe. Alright, I'm ready. It's not bad. I'm gonna be honest, guys, like, I don't know how the fuck people make their charges go that fast.